Hi, this is Dr. Fox, and let's talk about the pharyngeal muscles. In this video, we'll discuss the wall of the pharynx and the individual muscles which comprise it. The pharynx, as the aerodigestive pathway, is predominantly a muscular structure which is lined by mucosa. There are two separate sets of pharyngeal muscles, three pairs in each set. The first set consists of three pharyngeal constrictors which nest within one another, a superior, a middle, and an inferior set. These muscles are going to attach to different elements of osteology and then meet their counterparts along the posterior margin and attach to them along a pharyngeal raphe. There are also three sets of longitudinal muscles, one of which is visible here. Muscles are going to attach to different osteological elements and insert either in the wall of the pharynx or to the larynx, which, when activated, shorten and widen the pharynx. All of these muscles, with the exception of the stylopharyngeus, are innervated by the pharyngeal neural plexus. But let's take a better look at these muscles. So the pharyngeal constrictor muscles consist of the superior pharyngeal constrictor, the middle pharyngeal constrictor, and the inferior pharyngeal constrictor. These are innervated by the pharyngeal neural plexus, and when activated, they serially constrict so as to serially constrict the pharynx and push any materials along distally. They originate on various osteological structures. So, for instance, the superior pharyngeal constrictor arises from elements of the skull, so both the cranium and the mandible, and a connection of investing fascia known as the pterygomandibular raphe. The middle pharyngeal constrictor originates on the hyoid bone, and the inferior pharyngeal constrictor originates on cartilaginous elements of the larynx, namely the thyroid cartilage and the cricoid cartilage. Three of these muscles meet their counterparts on the posterior edge and form a seam called the pharyngeal raphe. The longitudinal muscles also are going to originate on various elements of the bony skull. So we have the stylopharyngeus that comes from the styloid process. We can see that coming down here. Stylopharyngeus, if you recall from our discussions of the pharynx, when it's invested by mucosa, is what forms that pharyngoepiglottic fold, that boundary between the oro and a laryngopharynx. There are also two other muscles. There's the salpingopharyngeus, which you don't really need to know the name of, and the palatopharyngeus, which come down, blend together, and insert in the wall of the pharynx. Activated, these three muscles are going to elevate the larynx. And what that does is it both shortens pharynx so as to help move materials along distally through the pharynx and down through the esophagus. Longitudinal muscles, with the exception of stylopharyngeus, are all innervated by the pharyngeal neural plexus. The stylopharyngeus muscle is innervated efferently by the glossopharyngeal nerve, or cranial nerve number 9. So we've discussed the muscular wall of the pharynx and the constituent sets of muscles. This is your summary slide. Thank you very much for your time.